There we go. We got any booze over here? I guess maybe I just hadn't turned my computer off in a while. I've just been putting it to sleep every night because I go to bed working on stuff. This goes to show, take care of your machine. Or it'll shit its pants in front of a very tiny worldwide audience. Hey.
Go on. What you got for me, Captain?
Do you love me?
How do you feel about us?
Well, I'm still here, ain't I?
Oh, it's so hot.
You must be doing something right.
That's all.
Fine.
If you're still there, Rob, what is the temperature like around you guys? Are there any more places in here I didn't explore yet? Yeah, that's all good stuff. Going all right. We had a little bit of a technical issue a little bit ago, so I had to restart my computer, but aside from that, everything's going okay. Just can't really go into any of these buildings. You guys gotta get out of the way. You guys got any booze in here? I think I need just one more drink of non-beer alcohol and he will love me. So having a chill Friday, that's always good. It's the best kind of Friday. Well, that looks kind of pretty. I'm looking forward to tonight. We're gonna try playing some more Borderlands 3 and making steak for dinner. And then tomorrow I have the whole morning off, so I'm pretty excited. I guess whiskey doesn't grow on trees. I won't just find it wandering out in the wilderness. Unless it does grow on trees. It has been pretty good. It is a little janky right now. Like, it needs some stability patching for sure. Oh. I went up to Arcadia without even realizing it. Now, what bums me out is there's a really cool extension that Twitch has for it, but I guess some people have been saying it messes up the stream, and our, like, last two streams of Borderlands have just eventually just died. So, we're gonna turn that off when we try streaming tonight. Is there any alcohol out here? But the shooting feels good, and the humor, as dumb as it is, makes me chuckle, so. And there's a lot of guns. Hello. Damn it, I need to eat up shotgun shells. Give those to me. Is there anything I can see from up here that looks interesting? Nope, most of the fog. I'm not super a huge fan of really grindy stuff, but I definitely like Borderlands. I think there was definitely a time I really could get into a game just about grinding. But now there's just so many games I want to play. Anything anywhere? Oh, there's a monster here somewhere. Boom! What you got? Oh. No one has any legendary rifles that I want. Longfellow, do you love me yet? Yeah, you'd say something. Do these guys have any alcohol? You guys hiding your bourbons? No, just drugs. And he doesn't like it when you do drugs, I guess. Party pooper. Will should be home in a little bit. At least I think so. I don't think he was taking a longer day today like he has been. Whew. Guess I could check in this hotel again. I didn't really look around for alcohol. I was too busy murdering all of the super mutants. Give a quick sweep. If I can remember how to get in. There we go. So how do you even get inside? Yeah, this is running much better now. I'm glad I restarted my computer. Ugh, gross. Longfellow idolizes me.
Hey.
Yeah.
All right, let's talk.
I appreciate it, Captain. At my age, any chance to make a new friend is, well, it ain't something I'd expect to happen much, but I'm glad it did. There's more to it than that, though. Long time ago, when I was a young man, I had a sweetheart. Hannah was her name. And we planned to get married, raise a family, and all that. Well, we had a place out in the fog we used to meet so we could be alone. Damn children of Adam jumped us. They took her and left me for dead. Took 2 months to recover from my injuries. By then, it was too late.
Oh, those dicks.
They warped her mind and turned her into their ways. It was only later I learned she was carrying our child. Of course, the baby didn't stand a chance with all that radiation. Adam's will, she called it. Anyway, she died a few years later. Trappers got her. Or so them lunatics said. I guess that was Adam's will, too.
I didn't know. I'm so sorry, Longfellow.
Yeah. Well, we all got our scars, right? Truth is, what happened to Hannah was her choice. And so be it. I never got to be a father, and that's what I regret. If I had a son or daughter, well, I'd have someone to pass on all my learning to. But you, you're the first person I've met that's worth teaching what I've
got.
Well,
thank you, Longfellow.
I ain't good with telling people that I'm grateful, but you've given this old hunter a sense of purpose and a reason for living. That's something I ain't had for a long time.
That means a lot.
Thanks, Longfellow. It means a lot to me that you think so.
Well, that was all I had to say. I appreciate you hearing me out.
Huh. I thought he had a mission.
Make it quick, will you? What can I do for you, Captain?
What do you think about our relationship?
I've had a hell of a time running with you, Captain. Got no regrets.
That's all for now.
Whatever you say.
I'm so sure that maybe he comes later or something where you have a mission and it's to go kill a monster or something, and then he goes, I want you to have this treasure, and it's like a big ass harpoon gun that's really good, and I'm just like, why haven't you been using this the whole time? Alright, good. We're just gonna head back then, grab Nick, and we can start crushing through the rest of the content. I think the next thing I'd want to do is that murder mystery. That sounds fun. Back to Longfellow's cabin. I do wish my vertebrate grenades worked here, though. Fallout 4 murder on the Orient Express. That'd be cool. Then I could finally be Poirot. In here. Ammo box. Turns out all of the robots did it.
That's it.
Dude, why is that ammo even dropping anymore? A bloodthirsty yell. Oh, did it kill you? Surprising. Why don't you have the patience to make a microphone work? I don't know. Did your new mic show up today? Specking into Mysterious Stranger after this, just for the fun of it. I've never used the Mysterious Stranger in Fallout 4. And since I'll have Nick with me for the rest of the game, I know he has a whole bunch of like weird, funny lines. One ghoul is just sleeping there. He didn't know I was a coming. You got more ammos?
Show me what you got.
Let's see.
Fog. It's dangerous,
Brooks,
okay?
How can the bait shop help you?
Let's barter.
Happily.
You got my ammo? I don't think you do. Nope. think as I've gotten older, fixing technical issues has gotten something I sort of enjoy, because it's like, I figured out the machine. I know this is sort of a weird thing. It was an issue on our microphone that we had to fix. Is if you have looked at it in your device manager, is the output and the input signal for your microphone, even though it is a microphone, the same thing? Because, like, for our, when we got our nice mic that we use now, the computer default set them at different things and it wouldn't work. So I had to go in and change the settings. Where's Nick? There you are.
Nick.
Time to hit the road?
Yeah, let's go.
Let's head out.
Well, all right.
Longfellow's cabin. Oh, they don't have any little exchange dialogue? That's lame. Yeah, if you see sound settings, I'm trying to remember how. Yeah, manage sound devices. Nope, that's not it. How do you get that to work? Open this on Windows 10. Well, I think I was wrong with what my idea was, so I'm not quite sure how to make it work. Well, 'cause I think I remember how to do with Windows 8 is like if you right click down on like the little sound bar thing and when it asks you to open sound settings. It normally then does like a little pop-up that's like playback, recording, whatever, those are the different tabs, and you just need to find your device under both playback and recording, go up in advanced, and then you go to like what frequency level it's at, and they both need to be at the same hertz level. There's normally like 5 or 6 choices to pick. And if they're at different levels, it freaks out. But if you put them at the same, in a hertz that the microphone can handle, then it works. Alright, so... just trying to remember how to bring up that menu in Windows 10. Because I remember it was easier to get to in 8. Because that's what I used on my laptop. Thank you. Yeah, I know you don't want to use it for playback. It's just they have to still be the same. Because, like, I don't use our Samson mic to play anything back, but if its playback was set too high or too low. Also, this is a weird thing. Since it's not working through USB, do you know whether or not that headphone only works with, like, USB 3 or something? Wishes to die. The microphone was only like a $25 mic. I don't think that might be true. That's what the Turtle Beach headset I was borrowing from Evan for a while. Yeah, that's all the USB was for. Ow, rude. All the way back there. Killed. Hiding in the dark. Got him. Oops, wrong button. Also, Trevor, ready to do that. Yeah, right click. Sound icon. Open sound settings. Aha. Yeah, okay. So, Robert, if you're there, are you when you open the properties for your device and you go to advanced and it has your format, it should say something like 2-channel, 16-bit, and then like an amount of hertz, like 48,000 or something. You just do that for both the input and then select it again for the output if you can, and then make sure those are both exactly the same. And if that doesn't do anything, then, well, I am unsure of what to do. I hit him with a sword. Wow, that did so little damage compared to my bullets. How to do it. Who's left? Oh, I walked right over you. Landmines. Oh, can she set those off? I guess so. Over there, what are you guys shooting at? Oh, I hear monsters. Oh, what the fuck? There we go, all saved. Haha. Let's go, Pearl. That's right, I don't need any more booze. Oh, that's right, I've hit max affinity with all of my friends. We did it. Oh, I don't have to care what anyone thinks about me anymore. Alright. Yeah, mysterious stranger. Ah! Missed. Whoa, my dog was just birthing itself out of that monster. Because we haven't even gotten to the mission yet. Hear more goopers. What fuck did you come from? Where's the mysterious stranger when you need him? Take that, monsters. Oh no. Oh no. Nice! I'm glad that worked. Good tech support by bad people or whatever. Nice, more antibiotics. Give me those drugs. Best tech support, thank you very much. Pearl, are you coming?
This elevator leads to the exclusive area of the hotel. You should feel quite privileged that they will be allowing you in.
Okay. I feel the privilege. Hey, Nick. Just kind of flipped right in here. Any cool stuff? A light bulb. I guess that's pretty cool. Oh, is this a vault? Cool. Probably have to open it with this. Yes, okay, I was like, what's happening?
I'm the detective.
Thank goodness. Let me just open the door for you.
Freaked out. He was asking me multiple different questions at once. Now, in that instance, is it saying best tech support in North America? Because I'm not sure what NA means.
About time the police sent someone out to investigate. We have many important residents and they are very worried.
Okay.
Nice. What happened? Who died?
It's Mr. Parker, the primary owner and financier for the hotel. This is just a disaster.
Okay.
Crime scene again.
Sounds like trouble.
Don't they realize that they're going to disturb the evidence? You'd better come with me, detective.
Okay. Gonna go solve a murder. More robo brains.
What the hell is wrong with you?
This robo brain is a crazy person. That does sound good, and I do like spicy things. I haven't had Gordetto's in a forever.
Is this blood? Looks like the brain enclosure was smashed.
Hello.
There we go. Baseball bat. What is this doing here?
Someone hit him with a baseball bat.
Residents are robots.
Not robots, Detective. Well, not exactly, anyway. I believe the term they use is robo-brain. Back before the war, the residents decided the best way to wait it out was to put their brains inside robots.
I've never been, like, a huge, like, Gardetto's fan person, but yeah, when people were like, you can just buy the rye chips, it's the best, I was like, okay.
Tell me about the victim.
Mr. Ezra Parker was the primary owner.
My sister loves Gardetto's. I'd say they might be her favorite, like, chip-ish snack, if I remember correctly.
It was his idea to have our premier clients become investors in the vault section.
But I didn't even know they made spicy Gardetto's.
He worked with Vault Tech to have this built to their every specification. Was there anything else?
I found the murder weapon.
Oh, no. That's the bat from Mr. McKinney's movie. You don't think he could be involved, do you? I can't imagine him ever doing such a thing. Was there anything else?
I'm not sure where I should start.
I suppose you should try to figure out how he died, and then who had the means and motive to kill him. Once you have enough evidence, was there anything else?
No.
Never mind.
I'll be
Let's
here.
Do a murder mystery. Is there a bed here I can lay down on? Excuse me. Or does that get rid of my rads? It doesn't get rid of my rads. What the fuck? Oh, good. There is a bed I can sleep on. A little parched. I guess we'll start by talking to Santiago. Hey, bud. I don't really want to talk to you next to this generator, but whatever.
Art is life. Without it, we are no different than animals.
Oh, so many checks. Okay.
Tell me, what does this piece say to you?
It's about composition. The balance of color and emotion.
Robert, is this what people are like at art galleries? trees in space. I kind of want to pick that one.
It looks like trees in space. Maybe it's about the struggle to maintain life adrift in an empty void.
Only the people who are good at art gathering. Gallerying. That is just a cat. If this is bullshit.
It's cute, I guess. Some people like that kind of thing.
More than you would imagine. Truth be told, this is my best-selling piece. I did this series under a pseudonym, of course. The series has meant more money.
I had to schmooze at a couple of art galleries. I was like, that does not sound like a very Robert thing. Going. Oh. Itchy nose. Wait, why did we do this whole loop? We could have just come right back downstairs. Who else has an itchy nose?
Tell me about yourself.
What is there to tell? I am one of the premier artists in the world. My work is primarily in oil paint. But
is he sneezing a whole bunch or something?
Sculpture or performance art as well.
It sounds like you've done a lot of paintings of Gilda. In love with Gilda, aren't you?
So what if I am? What business is it of yours? She deserves someone who truly understands her ephemeral beauty, not that brute actor.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
The person you should be looking at is Juliana Reed. That Philistine would not know art from her own excrement. She and
Damn.
Ezra had a rather dramatic fight recently. You could hear her banshee screeches all the way across the hotel.
He sucks on his feet?
I don't know. I was painting at the time and I was trying to block it out. Though I bet Gildo probably heard them. Maybe you should check with her.
Maybe later.
Good. I hope my paintings are able to open your mind.
Gross.
Of course. Silly me.
Just let me have a look at the neural interface matrix and I'm sure I can clear that.
No. No, it's not that. I've just caught another cold. Probably something that I finally sent for all out.
Oh, God. Not this again. Last month you were convinced you had the measles.
You're not a doctor. What would you even know about it? Besides, I think it may be malaria.
First of all,
ooh, slammed doctors of robotics.
Secondly, I've told you time and again, you can't get sick inside the suit. It's not physically possible.
I know when I'm getting sick, Bert.
Oops. Sounds like Will's home.
Wander off and play in your lab. Mr. Scruffy and I are going to rewrite the will, so he will get everything when I die, because horrible Bert didn't believe me.
Oh, God, Juliana. Whatever. I'm going to the lab.
Wait, what? Hello.
Tell me about yourself.
I'm afraid that's really all I should say about it. I mean, it is still classified, but I wanted to help with the investigation. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
Gross. But thank you for sending me that picture.
I heard that Juliana and Ezra had an argument few days before he was found dead. Tell me about that.
Well, I was in my lab at the time, so I didn't hear it. But Juliana has always been rather critical of Mr. Parker. I think she found something in the overseer's office. I wasn't listening when she told me about it. I kind of had my head in my research. I don't know, really.
But now I know I can get pictures on my phone. My old phone. Anytime you sent a picture, I just freaked out.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
Oh, well, that's not really my field of expertise, but I'm sure there are probably some clues at the crime scene. Oh, was there some?
Maybe later.
Very well. I'm just...
Okey-doke. Hey, lady. Oh, where'd the lady go?
Hello, Detective. Did you have a
question about the Hades murder? Tell me
about yourself. I'm Juliana Riggs, heiress to the Riggs fortune and wife of Bert Riggs. I'm not sure what else you expected, Detective.
I heard you had a big fight with Ezra a few days ago. Care to explain?
Oh, well, it wasn't that big a deal, really. He wanted more money to pay for repairs on the hotel. I wasn't feeling well that day and lashed out a bit at the poor man. I really should have listened to him more.
What's with all the junk in here?
These are our things. We're just waiting till the war blows over so we can bring them back to mansion.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
If you ask me, it's one of those actors. Or that horrible painter. Their type is always the cause of violence.
What a philistine.
Good luck catching the murderer, Detective.
Okay, have fun riding to that desk, I guess. Nick, you're not helping me with this case. Come on.
Protect and serve.
Okay, that's Bert. I know there are two more people in here. Are you the murderer?
I found your baseball bat at the crime scene. Care to explain how it got there?
Oh, we were just rehearsing a scene. Nothing to worry about.
I found your baseball bat.
Oh.
Okay, just let me know how I can...
Wait, no. Nick.
Hello, Detective. How can I help? Did you have questions about the case?
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
It's obviously Santiago. He keeps going back to look at the crime scene.
Never mind.
Okay. Just let me know how I can help.
Where'd the other one go? I don't remember where the beach is in here.
Perfect.
Cool. That will save me a step for later, I think. Is the beach over here? Nope. Look at all these weights. These robots are gonna get shredded and then rise up against us. Where is that beach? Hey, concierge. This place is gross up here. Some food. I don't think the beach is up here. Other side of the vault. It's the exit zone. Residential. I was already in there. Is there a beach room? Security. Go to the beach? Yes. Legs for days.
Stories from the silver screen rather than talk about that nasty murder business.
All right.
Did you know they were thinking of making a TV show of the Silver Shroud? Between you and me, Keith's agent had an inside track to get him the role. Did you need something else?
Hey, bud.
Tell me about yourself.
How was work?
Apparently, Juliana had a big argument with Ezra a few days before he died. Did you happen to overhear any of the conversation?
Oh, yes. I haven't seen a woman go off like that since Teresa Dubois fired her costume designer. But to get back to your question, it was fever pitch, detective. She had apparently gone to the overseer's office to check on the state of things and found it in horrible disrepair. But, and this is where it gets interesting, it sounds like she found something that really set her off. Couldn't hear what, though. Did you need something else?
I found Keith's baseball bat at the scene of the murder. Any thoughts on how it got there?
I don't know, detective. I can't really imagine Keith killing Ezra. Did you need something else?
I've gotten the impression you've had an affair with Santiago.
Look, I love Keith, I do. But sometimes he just can't give me the attention I need.
So much robot scandal.
It only lasted a few dozen years. The man's a bit much, even. Did you need something?
What were you and Keith talking about when I came in?
Oh, that? We were rehearsing. Gotta stay sharp. Did you need something?
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
Well, it is a bit strange how obsessed Santiago has been. Uh-huh. He did a whole series of paintings of me, hundreds.
maybe later.
I'll be around.
Alright, to the overseer's office. So I guess first I should just lay down. But now Will is free to become the greatest stream artist ever. I don't really feel like the game has given me many things to think about in terms of who a murderer could be. It's just been like, him, not him. There hasn't been like, it's weird how he keeps disappearing all the time or something. Where would the overseer? Over there, I guess. How do I get over there? Oh. Well, that's good. Gonna ask how that meeting went. All right.
Progress on construction of the second wing of the vault is completely stalled. Once a premier area of the vault had been completed, funding seems to have been cut off. My supervisors have informed me that they haven't received payment. Vault-Tec won't pay out of pocket to continue construction. I've repeatedly approached Ezra about the finances, but he keeps telling me that Mrs. Riggs hasn't transferred the funds. However, when I asked her, Juliana said that she had just given Ezra extra for the gold paint in the rooms. I've hired an investigator to look for signs of embezzlement in a few weeks.
So what is going on here? All you need is to test the social interactions between the working class and the ultra-wealthy under combined conditions. Working in conjunction with the staff from the Cliff's Edge Hotel, this function as a luxury hotel to attract necessary subjects. Upon beginning the test, additional subjects shall be admitted from the local population. Okay. Whoops. Prior to vault show. Function, ultra elite hotel. Okay. Group A. This is Group A. Not to number more than 10. Shall have their every issue and desire attended to. Group B shall begin numbering 300 and shall be restricted to the second wing of the vault. Measures should be taken to ensure the living conditions are uncomfortable and cramped. Okay, so they're trying to make a class war. It's clear that one of the subjects from Testing Group A is apparently a researcher. He and his wife have convinced the other members of Group A that with their situation becoming tense once again, their best chance to outlast the war is to have their brains inserted into these robots, and they're doing this voluntarily. Okay, it's insane. This is fucking up the tests. Okay. Received an activation notice from Vault-Tec to begin the test, despite the second wing still being incomplete. However, when I attempted to trigger the recruitment protocol for B, the system informed me I've been locked out. Someone from Test Group A seemed to have overridden the system. Oh. Yeah, it's been weeks now, and I realize today that I've become the test subject instead of testing the social interactions between the locals and the group of rich assholes. It's just me trapped in here with them. We're going to live forever, and I have to deal with them for the rest of my life. That sucks.
Sounds like Ezra was embezzling from his investors.
I'll eject that holo tape just so I have it. Alright. I need to listen to that tape again just to make sure I know what's going on. So Overseer, is that what it was? That's not what I need. Fuck. Am I playing until 4? Yes. Damn it, what was the name of that tape? Oh well, okay. Back to investigating everyone, I guess.
Protect and serve.
My fellow connoisseur of the art, here to see my latest work.
I think you should explain why you keep returning to the crime scene.
Others do not like to think about it, but even we shall die someday. Like Prometheus's torch, it kindles within me the fire to create as much art as I can. Benedicta.
Oh,
never mind. Some evidence that Ezra was embezzling from you and the other investors.
Oh, well, I really don't believe that. Mr. Parker wouldn't do such a thing, I'm sure.
Never mind.
Good luck catching the murderer, Detective.
Is this really just all the information I have to go off of?
Hello, Detective. How can I help? Did you have questions about the case?
Never mind.
Okay. Just let me know how I can help.
What was the name of that hollow tape that I picked up? Because I don't remember. Oop. Trying to remember what it is. Who? Okay.
Have you noticed Juliana acting strangely lately?
Oh, well, I'm probably just being paranoid, but she's been so much more pleasant lately. I mean, it's been nice, but also a bit unnerving. Most people don't really understand us, but I always appreciated how she can just take charge of a situation. It's what allowed me to focus on my research. I'm worried something has happened to her. She doesn't seem like the same person. Was there something else, Detective?
What do you mean Juliana's not the same person?
My wife has always been a very harsh woman, Detective. I don't know who it is in our rooms, but that is not my wife, Detective. Was there something else?
Never mind.
Very well.
Okay. Oh, man. is that Juliana? Because they all look the same. Option to say, maybe if I do that. Like, I don't know what it wants me to do with Santiago or anything, because I guess since I can accuse him of murder, that's what that thing's for.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder? Tell me about yourself.
I'm afraid.
Okay.
Never mind.
Am I missing something?
Protect and serve.
I guess I can say I think you're the murderer.
Hello, detective. Did you have a question about the heinous murder?
I think you're the real murderer.
That's just silly, detective. Why would I want to kill Mr. Parker?
Maybe you could give me a reason it couldn't be you.
I'm sick all the time, detective.
Ezra was embezzling your money.
You were so clear.
It's a shame. I thought I could keep the ruse going.
I was right.
Had to end eventually, I suppose. This doesn't have to end in more violence, detective. Just walk away. I'll leave, and you can tell them I escaped.
Why did you kill Juliana?
I hadn't planned on it, but Juliana figured out what I was doing and had to be dealt with swiftly. I thought I could get a bit more money out of this place before making my escape. What's it going to be, detective? Join me in...
Not a chance. Your murder spree stops here.
Then let...
Boom. A lot of money.
Hey, toss anything you can't haul my way.
Brain Dead Part 2. Why'd that need to be a Part 2?
Protect and serve.
I found the killer.
It was Ezra. He killed Juliana and took her place to hide his tracks.
My word. I never thought Mr. Parker was capable of something like this.
He attacked me, but it's over now. Your residence, you're safe.
There you are, detective. Payment for your services and a bonus for uncovering such a heinous plot. I don't think we could have done it without you.
Thanks for all this pre-war money. Sorry your wife's dead. Oh. Now they're not characters I can talk to anymore.
Is everyone all right? Is everyone all right?
That's lame. Okay, whatever. Santiago, anything for you to say?
Something sounded exciting, detective.
I guess. All right. Well, that was that. Time to get on with the main story. Come on, Nick. We've still got like an hour of stuff to do.
Good day to you.
Good day to you. Well, that was a fun-ish little quest. I mean, I didn't really have to use any sort of logic or anything to figure it out. Basically just, oh man, bad things happened here. Yeah, this is a vault. Neato Spaghettos. The twist at the end was pretty neat. That felt like something that could have been a movie twist. Got any food in this lunchbox? Yes. Oh, Final Fantasy X. The game. Let's learn about Arcadia. This game is on my top 10 list. Your Final Fantasy top 10 list. The joke didn't work, never mind.
When I first climbed this mountain above the fall, I thought to myself, now here is a metaphor worth taking in. You've entered a place of understanding. Peace.
Hey, other Nick.
While you're here in Arcadia, Synthkind welcomes you as long as you welcome us.
I came here looking for Kasumi Nakano.
Really? I'm impressed. Few would brave the kind of journey you've had for the sake of someone else. Kasumi is here. She's safe and unharmed. You're free to see her if you like. Before you do, though, tell me, you think Kasumi is a simp?
We're not answering any more questions until you play straight with us. Just who the hell are you, really? There's only one synth with that kind of face and a mind of his own. And I only see him when I look in a mirror.
Nick, it can't be you.
Don't give me that. What are you trying to pull? I've never seen you before.
Oh man, I'm glad I brought Nick.
If you're willing to give
Howie, how did I know he was Dima? He didn't say his name was Dima.
Over a century ago, when we were first created, we were prototypes, Nick. The first synths capable of independent thinking and judgment.
Keep talking.
One of the Institute's experiments had to do with how our brains could process personality. If we could handle individualized feelings and behaviors, I was allowed to develop mine based on experience. But with you, they wanted to try transferring an entire personality into you. It took several attempts before the personality imprint worked. I saw you wake up not knowing who or what you were so many times. I couldn't let them do it to you anymore. We were the only two prototypes they made. I literally saw myself in you. You were my brother, Nick. I helped you escape the Institute. We left together.
If I were your brother, I'd remember.
That's where you'd be wrong. This happened over a century ago. There's only so much memory that can fit into the prototype brains we have.
I've heard enough.
I think you and I need to talk about this. Maybe not now, though.
Is it really possible that you wouldn't remember any of this?
You mean between the Institute failsafes, the beatings I've taken over the years, and plain old age? Or are you buying this hole? There's only so much room of their argument. I don't know. It's not like we've got the instruction manual.
Nick, is he really your brother?
If he is, it's news to me. Synths even be related? It's because we're from the same assembly line. Does that make us family? I gotta think about this.
We'll talk later. This is a lot to take in.
Nick, I don't need you to believe me. I'm just glad to see you again. Whenever you're ready, I'll be here. Now, about young Kasumi. It's important that you understand exactly why she's here. I asked you before if you think she's really a sin. If you could indulge me with an answer.
What she is important.
But it is. It's everything. Imagine just looking at your own hands and having to wonder, was I born with these, or were they manufactured? None of us take this transition lightly. She's facing the possibility of her entire life being a lie, that someone stripped her very identity from her and made her into something she isn't. I want you to understand that before you see her. She has a chance here to live as a synth, not hiding, not pretending to be something else. One more question, if you'll indulge me. You're here for Kasumi, but I suspect there could be another reason you came to us. Tell me, are you a synth?
How would I even know?
I'm afraid if you're looking for some biological test we can do, there isn't any. None that aren't fatal. Instead, you have to look for the signs, holes in someone's memory, feelings of unexplained isolation.
Am I a synth?
Ultimately, you have to decide for yourself. What do you believe?
I'm a human being, not a synth.
Are you sure? I don't mean to question you, but what's the first memory you have?
Well, that's not fair. I don't know what memory my character has.
With my wife. getting ready for the day. I had to take care of my boy, Sean. And, well, a lot's happened since then.
But no memories before then. No childhood. Your first best friend. Your first kiss. That's usually a sign. Data is easy to migrate, but feelings, that's a hard thing to transfer into another mind. Isn't it funny how a memory can feel like a whole different reality? People, places, even sounds and colors can change. Or someone else has changed them. I won't lie to you. There will always be other explanations. Trauma, disease, the background radiation, they all take their toll on the mind. But I can promise you that you will be accepted here. Whatever you decide is true for yourself.
Thank you. You've given me a lot to think about.
I'm glad to hear it. Acadia is open to you. Feel free to walk.
I mean, I wouldn't be a synth because I was the backup for the stuff, right?
Faraday and Chase, and I'm sure you're eager to talk to Kasumi. She's...
You should know the Institute has been destroyed.
What? It's over. No more courser hunts? No more slavery? But that also means the technology to make the synths is lost. Our origins have been buried. Not to mention the loss of human life. Sorry. I'm not going to judge the actions of someone who's wiped out a great evil. You have our gratitude. Is there anything else you need?
Part of a group that helps synths. The railroad.
Really? I don't understand why a group dedicated to helping synths would convince them through fear that their only option is to hide. Yes, they volunteer for the memory wipe. Yes, not knowing you're a synth makes it harder for the Institute to find you. But the cost. I know how frightening it is. Risk of capture, but sacrificing what you are, avoiding the true struggle to be accepted as our own form of life.
I hadn't thought about it like that. I'm sorry.
So am I. Your heart is in the right place, and it's unfair of me to judge. While I enjoy
I'm also, yeah, I've never finished the story and then talked to Dima, so this is pretty interesting.
Is there anything else I can do for you?
So, everyone here in Acadia is a synth?
Yes. Either they were escapees we managed to find before the Institute could, or they were victims of a mind wipe, and we revealed the truth to them.
Who are you? What's your story?
I came to this island over a century ago, hiding from my creators, the Institute. But after my escape felt secured, I was left with nothing. No programmed task. No false memories. I spent a year just sitting in a cave. Just sitting. One day, it finally occurred that maybe I could decide for myself what to do, who I was. I've been doing that ever since. Was there anything else?
Tell me more about this place, Acadia.
All I want is to bring as many synths here as I can, and give them a chance to know what they really are, to embrace it. Beyond that, we just want to live in peace. I don't have any grand plans for expansion. Just existing as we are now is enough. Was there
for
anything
now.
Else?
I should get going.
Of course.
Perhaps I've been there a long time. Are you feeling all right?
I'm fine. You worry too much.
Sometimes I feel like you don't worry enough. You know we blew 3 more relays this week. I'm coming in. You stay right there.
Hey, whoop. She just disappear? Richard, there we go.
Synths definitely deserve to be safe, just like everyone else.
It's so good to hear that. Very encouraging.
Ooh, you, the crazy
monster
person.
Make sure Dima knows that as well. He's put so much of himself into this. All his time and energy devoted to helping others. He never stops to think of himself. Sometimes I worry about... Well, if I wasn't here to make sure his equipment is all functional. And that's not even mentioning maintaining the fog condensers. So many things to keep track of.
Seems like he's lucky to have you helping.
Thank you. That's very kind.
If there's anything I can do to help out, just let me know.
Well, if you're determined to help, there is something you could do. There's a boat along the coast of the island. It was transporting some hardware we needed. Storage drives. The boat never finished the trip, you see. So the drives are still up. My understanding is that the boat wrecked southwest of here. So,
what happened
to the boat?
Why didn't it make it?
I'm not entirely sure, to be honest. Trappers, fog crawlers, there's no end to what's out there. What might still be out there. But the point is that we already lost someone once. I don't want to see...
Let's do it.
Sure thing, Faraday. I'll get the drives for you.
Thank you.
Okay. Where is... other lady, she is downstairs.
I assume you're not planning on staying long.
Is there a problem with my being here?
Maybe. Maybe not. Acadia is only as secure as we make it. We take unnecessary risks, we get careless, and things can go bad. Fast. If there's a synth who needs a safe place, then we take them in. Let them live as a synth, without fear. That makes you an unnecessary risk. It's nothing personal. Minimizing our contact with outsiders is just practical.
Is there anything I can say or do to change your mind?
Just don't cause any problems.
I can do that.
You got it right. Look! Is killing me. Now's not a good time.
What's wrong?
We're doing this anyway? Even after saying I don't want to talk? God. You try having somebody botch a mind wipe on you and see how it feels. Then get back to me, okay?
I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Yeah, well...
Goodbye.
Acadia may not look like much from the outside, but it's all some of us have got. It certainly wasn't what I was expecting, but it means there's hope, right?
That's a good attitude. Hope can get you through the worst of times.
Believe me,
but
I know.
It can't get you through
when
the worst
escaped,
of Final Fantasy.
I had no idea what to do with myself. I was so lost. But I heard rumors of Chase and what she was doing, and she was bringing people to a safe. And now here I am.
So now you're here.
here, what comes next?
Final Fantasy 13, one of the characters is named Hope.
I've just got to keep telling myself I'm better off here than dead.
So you're that new fellow from the Commonwealth. It's so wonderful to meet someone from back home. I'm afraid Kasumi doesn't seem to want to discuss it, but...
You're not missing anything.
Day, I think.
Oh, that's so good to hear. I would like to see it again someday, once things settle down here. Acadia is all well and good, I suppose.
I thought 12 was pretty alright.
It does get a bit boring.
You're safe here. That's what really matters.
I suppose. One could do with a little excitement now and then, though. Don't you think? I'm sure I'll see you around. Do take care.
You're new here too, huh? I mean, I haven't been here that long myself. Honestly, I'd be dead right now if it weren't for Chase. Turns out it's pretty hard to live as a synth in the Commonwealth.
It's a tough world. For everyone, not just synths.
I'm not saying it isn't. Just, most folks don't want to kill you simply because you exist. I'll see you around, okay?
I can't wait to get out of here.
Three of those are using ATB.
You're in travel.
Oh, okay. So tired in this game, so fast. Indeed.
Circuitry is completely fried.
Hey, Kasumi.
Kasumi Nakano?
Sorry, I'm right in the middle of something.
Your parents sent me. They want you to come home.
They did what? You came all this way for me. Look, my mom and dad, I mean, those people that were taking care of me, they wouldn't want me back. Not if they knew the truth. I'm not their daughter. I'm a synth. I thought if I just left, it would be easier for them. How would that conversation have gone anyway? I've been lying to you this whole time. Your real daughter is dead and I replaced her?
You haven't replaced anyone. Kenji and Rei are still your parents.
I really wish that was true. If I wasn't a synth, things would be so much simpler. Acadia isn't what I thought it was. There's more going on here than just the refuge. But I can't leave until I've gotten to the bottom of it. I've been running long enough.
If something's going on, then I can help. Just tell me what's happening.
I don't know how you could. Wait. Wait, of course you can help.
I do track down things, mainly because the god of video games just puts markers on important stuff for me to find, and I can just go and pick it right up.
Here, on this island, something way more important than just one lost girl.
All right, I'm listening.
Okay, where to begin? You saw all those computers that Dima's hooked up to, right? They hold his memories, or offload data from his brain. Maybe some combination of both? Well, Faraday asked me to help do some repairs on them. And, you know, I got curious. There's like a century's worth of life experiences in there. And that's when I see it. Data models Dima has been making. One was the fog taking over Far Harbor. Another was a nuclear detonation on the island. Plus, death counts. What if Dima is so open and welcoming because he's actually hiding something? To wipe out the rest of the island.
We should get to the bottom of this. If
Dima is putting on an act. We need to know.
I'll help if I can. But that's not much to go on.
I know. I've been working on that, but I haven't had much luck. I keep seeing Dima, Faraday, and Chase head into the laboratory at the other end of the hall. Then they come out later looking like they've been arguing. There's actually a storage space right next to there. It'd be a perfect spot to hide and eavesdrop. But it's been locked up. I've also tried breaking into Faraday's terminal, since he and Dima are so close.
I'll figure this out. Just stay here.
Okay. Good luck, and...
From one case to a new one. It's never easy for us, is it?
Okay. Need to find a Chase. Where is the stairs up? Found it. Oh, she was just in here.
You track Kasumi here. I'm impressed.
Is she a courser?
Not as quietly or efficiently as possible. But thankfully, she was never in any real danger. I'm afraid your journey was unnecessary.
I wanted to see for myself that she's safe.
You have my word. Acadia is a safe haven for synths. Were it not, I would not have aided anyone in reaching it. Every synth I've tracked down, every synth convinced to come here, has been assured that he or she will come to no harm. My job is to make sure they all remain safe, no matter what. Understand?
How do you manage to track down synths? Bring them here.
I have a network of contacts throughout the area. Some from my time with the Institute, some after. I know the Institute's tactics, and use that to my advantage. You have Dima's blessing.
So, what's your story?
I used to be a courser, returning synths that had escaped from the Institute. I was tracking a synth and instead found Dima. He convinced me of the truth and the error of my ways. I rejected the Institute, made sure they couldn't track me, and
I'd like to help you. Is there anything I can do?
Actually, as a matter of fact, there is. If you're serious about contributing. We've got a situation I need someone to look into. You've had some experience traveling around the island, so you may.
What's the problem?
We were expecting a new synth to arrive, and he should have been here by now. There's been no sign of him, and I'm concerned that he might have become lost on the way here.
You have any leads on where he might be?
You should start by talking to Brooks in Far Harbor. He's one of us, a synth. He's the one who meets the new arrivals
what?
And gets them started on the journey here. Of course, he's not likely to tell you anything without proof that you're...
Uh-huh.
If he doesn't cooperate, tell him that his designation is L7. That's as much help as I can give you for now. Please.
That's cool. Alright. Go talk to Brooks and be like, dude, you've been giving me sweet deals and you've been a synth this whole time? That's radical. Just even the storytelling in Far Harbor is better than Duke of World. Alright, so where am I going? Am I going north? I'm going north. Through the darkness. Gravity. I think we're back outside the town, so no problem at all. Oh, God. Well, Nick, there's nothing we can do because the radiation is literally fucking everywhere.
Bring it on, Island.
Hey, Brooks.
I got goods.
I need to talk to you about a missing synth.
Yeah. Well, it's not something I talk about with outsiders. So you can either buy something or move along.
I'm working with Chase. She told me that your designation is L792.
Okay, I believe you. Keep it down, all right? It's real private information.
Your eyes are crazy.
What you're talking about. He's a younger guy. Maybe early 20s with white hair. Goes by the name Derek. Thing is, he showed up way earlier than he was supposed to. Thought a courser was on his tail, so he rushed the timetable. To be honest, the guy was a wreck. He was scared shitless, looking over his shoulder every 5 minutes and attracting unwanted attention. I tried to calm him down, but he panicked and ran off into the fog. That was the last I saw of him.
Can you tell me anything else? I'm gonna need more information than that if I'm gonna find this synth.
I wish I had more to give you.
That synth could be wandering around out there right now, lost in the fog.
I've told you everything I know, all right? You think I wanted this to happen? Well, I didn't. Look, if you're really going after that synth, I'm pretty sure he took the road south out of town. You could hit that one. Just be careful out there. Thanks.
I mean, he looks like someone just was fucking around in the character creator and made a monster.
I feel like shit about what happened.
All right. He is probably dead. Derek. There's no sliding in this.
Meyer lurk. Oh, man.
I'm not looking for trouble. I just need to find someone. A young man with white hair. You help me, I'll leave.
Yeah. We found him. One of the fog's creatures already attacked him. He was bleeding out. You know, why waste the meat? Here. Well, what's left? Take it. Now go. Don't come back.
Okay. Is that just in my inventory? What? It's not in my miscellaneous. Oh, there it is. That's pretty fucked. Hey guys, we need to talk about what just happened.
You have what you wanted. Now go!
Well, okay. That was pretty fucked up. Them cananamanables. Yeah, probably have enough time to finish both of these side quests and turn them in. Thirsty. These dark forests at night. Burp. It's a good way to get attacked by monsters. Truth is, I am the greatest monster of all. Okay, I think I already came here a while ago and killed everyone here, so I don't think we're gonna have much of a problem. Victoria's trunk. Nothing I want there. Alright, let's go turn these in. Last time I was here, I was nearly out of ammo, but I have all the ammo now, so don't fuck with me, monster people. Or there will. And explosions. Mostly explosions. Oh no. I'm in irradiated water. Actually, that didn't seem to do anything to me. Weird. Send me to the Children of Adam. So I accidentally found their home base when I was wandering around, but I don't remember where that was. To start going up this mountain. Oh, I thought that was a wolf. There we go. And up we go. Not found anything that light goes into. Might be a healing item. Does it have a chemistry bench? Devices.
I've got those storage drives you asked for.
Oh, that's great. Thank you. Just the two? Really? I somehow thought there were three.
I did notice a locked chest that I couldn't open. Maybe the last one was in there. Do you have the key?
Key? Chest? I'm afraid I don't know. You know what? This is fine. Just these two. It's fine. Well, you did your part, so I'll do mine. Thank you for recovering these.
Your missing synth was junked by cannibal trappers. He didn't survive.
That poor bastard. That synth came here to live in peace, and we failed him in the worst way possible. It's my fault. I should have gone out there to meet him. Damn it all. I'm glad we were able to bring some closure to the matter.
You said this wasn't the first time a synth has gone missing.
Of course not. For someone without weapons or field training, crossing this island is deadly. Thanks again for your help. Be safe out there.
Thanks.
Yes?
Can you tell me about the fog condensers?
Oh, those? Dima and I designed them when it became clear the fog was only getting worse. They're effective, but have such a limited range. Dima insisted we provide them to the people of Far Harbor, and I'm so glad we did. Without the condensers, I'm not sure they'd have anywhere left.
Dima looks like he's had a lot of work done.
Well, that's certainly an understatement. Between the two of us, we've made so many modifications. He was just a prototype, never built for all this. It took a lot to overcome the limitations of the original design and expand his memory. It really is remarkable, isn't it? He's overcome so...
Tell me about yourself, Faraday.
Me? I don't know why you'd care. I escaped the Institute, just like others here. Never had my mind wiped, thankfully. I like to think I came along right when Demon needed me. I found him before all this, before Acadia. He needed my help. He's always been stubborn like that. Anyway, I've been by his side ever since, making sure he has ever...
Adorable.
Sorry. Never mind.
Okay.
Alright. Sleep quick, so that way I don't lose any progress. Is it a master level terminal? Yep. That Bermano. Some beds in here. Oh, wait, who's this guy? Hey, Cog.
Hey there.
Sounds like you got the all clear. So what's your story?
I came here looking for Kasumi.
Oh, isn't that sweet of you? That Kasumi's a good enough kid, I suppose. A little confused, maybe. Not that anyone's asking, but I'll tell you. It all gets easier to deal with when you realize none of it matters. What you are, where you came from, let go of all that, and life gets simple.
Yeah, I hear you.
Is that so? Huh. Most of the chumps here act like I'm out of my gourd. Good to know someone else sees it my way. Anyway, lately I've taken to amusing myself with trading. Don't have much to work with. Let me know if you need something.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Kasumi said she needed the key to the storage room downstairs. Can I borrow it?
Well, yeah, I guess. I mean, you could. But I lost it. Should never have agreed to help Faraday move. Like there could be anything I'm carrying that's going to damage Dima's computers. I was shoving things around in that upper floor that circles the wall of the telescope room, if that helps.
Hmm.
Need something?
I'll take a look, sure.
You never know, I might actually...
Looks like you have ammo. It's good enough for me.
If it weren't for Dima, most of us would
probably... Oh, where's like a good bed? There we go. Dima, we need to talk about you being a crazy person.
Hey, Dima.
Is there anything I can do?
Kasumi says she's seen parts of your memories. Death projections. For Far Harbor and the center of the island.
That's unfortunate. She should be focusing on herself. Her new life. She shouldn't have to bear the burden, please. This is a matter best left to me and my advisors. We aren't planning. Those projections were merely to help us realize the cost of inaction.
If this thing involves the whole island, then you need help. I can be your problem solver if you let me in.
I suppose there's something to be said about refusing help, even when it's offered and you're in need. There's a conflict that's been brewing on this island shortly after we built Acadia. Between Far Harbor and the Children of Atom.
Simply put, they want to kill each other, and each side wants us to help them.
We've tried to stay neutral, but Far Harbor was going to be wiped out by the fog, so that's when we built the condensers for them.
And I was friends with the previous leader of the Children of Atom, Confessor Martin. I even gave them their headquarters. The submarine base they named the Nucleus.
Which was a mistake, because Martin is gone and the new confessor, Tectus, is completely insane.
He's been threatening us to force us to choose a side. I left behind something very important in that submarine base I gave them.
Dima's earliest memories are stored in the military computer banks in that base. War security systems and Confessor Martin's goodwill were supposed to keep them safe.
But now Tectus is in charge, and he's after Dima's memories. We don't even know what's in them.
But we do know that I spent nearly a century on this island alone. Whatever's in there is too dangerous to allow Tectus to get his hands on them.
The Children of Atom on this island. You were helping them?
Yes. I know their faith in radiation as a type of god is a bit different, but who am I to judge? I was using a submarine base as a home when Martin and his followers stumbled inside. They had been cast out of Far Harbor for their beliefs. When I left to found Acadia, I knew the base would be in safe hands. They needed a home, but now Martin is gone. His successor, Tectus, wants to finally end the feud with Far Harbor by letting the fog swallow them.
You left your memories behind? How does that work?
As a prototype synth, my raw data capacity is limited. I began using computer banks to expand, to give me room to ponder, see new things. I had to leave some of my earliest memories behind when I left the sub-base to the Children of Atom. I thought they were safe.
You're keeping Far Harbor safe, is that it?
Not exactly. They're fiercely independent. But the fog was starting to choke more and more of the island. So I proposed a trade. We would give them the technology to keep the fog at bay. In return for them, unfortunately, the Children of Atom view the radioactive fog as a holy portent, and their bloodied history with Far...
So what can I do to help?
If you're willing to retrieve what I've lost and bring my memories back to me, then we'd all be one step closer to solving this conflict without bloodshed.
You'll have to get through the Children of Atom's base. You're new on the island.
so you might be able to pose as a recruit.
Then, once you get to the memory banks, you'll have to use a special program Dima and I have been working on to break through the security systems.
It's not going to be like a normal hack. You'll be breaking through a version of my own mental network. I've loaded the program with some instructions I've recorded that will help guide you through it. I'm afraid it's difficult to explain without seeing it for yourself.
I'll get your memories, Dima.
If we're lucky, the pre-war defenses have kept the children of Adam at bay. But that means you'll have to get past them yourself. One more thing before you leave. Whatever you do, our ultimate goal must be to bring peace. If you attack them, they'll consider themselves at war with the outside world.
If we find anything suspicious in those memories of yours, we'll be back. Count on it.
Yeah, let's go talk to Kasumi. And then we'll save, and we'll stop here for now. Who's this guy?
Katie is far away in the Institute.
Turns out Dima's earliest memories are in the hands of the children of Adam. He's afraid of what they're gonna find.
So, is that what those death projections were about? It wasn't Dima planning to destroy the island. He's worried the children of Adam will. Or is he still hiding something? What could be in those memories that he would leave them behind?
Is it Terra Strong?
Really something in them that's dangerous? Do you have a way in? Into his memories?
Got this program that Faraday and Dima wrote. It's supposed to help me access the memory banks.
Really? How would that work? When I was taking a peek in the computers he has here, Dima was hooked up to his chair. I was just tapping into it. I wonder if you'll need to, you know, connect to the old banks the way he does? Some kind of connection between your head and
the Matrix.
I'll bet that's it. And then Faraday's program would be translating Dima's thoughts and data.
Kasumi, you're such a nerd.
Any security guarding it. I'm sorry, I'm making assumptions. It's just, well, it's a little exciting.
I'll get Dima's memories. And then
Nick looks spooky behind me like a ghost. Alright, cool. So, that's the end of that. We'll pick up with the next mission and next time. Is there a bed down here? That would be cool. Now I have to go upstairs to lay down. That's ridiculous. It's too many directions. Okay, well, I mean, that's understandable. We'll go and, ask which one. Can you tell me without telling me to keep it private? Well, in case you don't make it back, tell the Z-Man happy birthday from us as well. So let's get out of here and let's get into another stream with a raid. Who else is playing Fallout 4? Oh, it's Fallout 76. I was like, wait a minute, what? Oh, hey, Queen. She has that many. This person. Oh, they're a partner, even. The weirdest.
Or if it's one of those things where, you know, it seems like it is that. What am I doing? No.
Yeah, sure, we'll give them a try. But, tonight we're gonna play some Borderlands 3 again, hopefully, and it won't crash. We're gonna turn off that echo whatever thing, so hopefully that will not slow us down anymore, but We look forward to seeing you guys there, so bye.